thank you for joining us. You are watching the news on African Free Press Television. My name is Bridget Okudeli, and these are the stories we are tracking for you at this moment. The Petroleum Products Pricing Regulatory Agency, PPPRA, has said there was no provision for fuel subsidy in 2016 budget. The agency's clarification is coming on the heels of its recently released pricing template, which put the expected open market price of petrol at 91.30 kobo. The statement from the acting executive secretary of PPPRA, Mrs. Shotoya Oyoyo, explained that the funds from over-recovery in the first quarter Q1 shall be duly utilized for whatever noticeable imbalance in April 2016. In line with the price modulation principle, stakeholders are of the view that with expected open market price at 92.34 kobo, government will be subsidizing a litre with 5.80 kobo. But rather than subsidize, PPPRA said what shall exist is price modulation policy through which it considers and reviews pump price of petroleum quarterly. Condemnations have trailed the National Assembly's proposal to remove host communities' funds and local content from the Petroleum Industry Bill, PIB. Also, some members of the House of Representatives and prominent citizens from the Niger Delta, including Chief Ayiri Emami, Senator Roland Owi, and Senator Aniete Okon, fled the move by the National Assembly, describing it as capable of returning restiveness to the region. Reacting to the development, National Chairman Host Communities of Nigeria Producing Oil and Gas, HOSTCOM, Dr. Mike Emu, said the 10% equity was an executive proposal in the original bill expected to be paid by prospecting oil companies to the host communities. He also added that the money does not belong to the government. Barring any last-minute change, a detailed clean copy of the 2016 budget will be ready today for onward transmission to the president for assent. The presidency had last week said the budget would not be assented to by the president, Muhammad Buhari, because it did not contain the details. In reaction to the president, Chairman House of Representatives Committee on Appropriation, Abdul Mumin Jibrin, recalled that some provision administrations in the some previous administrations in the country, especially former President Olusegun Obasanjo, during his time, signed the budget without the details, which were made available 2 weeks later. And still in line, government of the United Kingdom has refuted claims of abandon towards the plight of the leader of the indigenous people of Biafra, Nnamdi Kanu, in prison. A spokesman for the British High Commission, Mr. Joe Abuku, made this disclosure in an email sent to Punch on Friday, April 1, 2016. Mr. Abuku was responding to an email regarding Nnamdi Kanu's letter to the High Commission. Mr. Abuku said the British High Commission has provided assistance to Mr. Kanu since his arrest in October last year, including visiting him regularly in prison and attending court appearances in an observation capacity. Kanu, who is also a British citizen, had written a letter through his lawyer, Ifeanyi Ejiofor, requesting the British government to intervene in his continued incarceration by the Nigerian government after he has been granted bail. And meanwhile, the office of the vice president has announced that an estimated $9 billion will be required for the rehabilitation and reconstruction of damaged infrastructure in the six northeast states of Adamawa, Bauchi, Borno, Gombe, Taraba, and Yobe. Out of the said $9 billion, over $6 billion is immediately needed to commence the recovery of the northeast region. Relying on a report of an exercise jointly put together by the federal government, the United Nations, the European Union, and the World Bank after the completion of the two-day validation and consensus building, the office announced that the World Bank had pledged to make $800 million available towards the rebuilding of the region. The Nigerian Labour Congress, NLC, has urged Nigerians to hold President Muhammad Buhari responsible for the acute fuel scarcity across the country, resulting in hardship for the Nigerian masses. Speaking through a communique issued at the end of its Central Working Committee, CWC, on Monday in Lagos, factional president of NLC, Comrade Joe Ajero, said his union frowned at the reoccurrence fuel scarcity and persistent long queues at the fuel stations across the country. A response to the fuel scarcity, which has remained unresolved for months, the Petroleum and Natural Gas Senior Staff Associate of Nigeria, Pengason, has ordered the federal government to declare a state of emergency in the oil sector. In a statement made available to the Nigerian Tribune on Monday, President of Pengason, Comrade Francis Johnson, argued that the solution to the insistent acute fuel scarcity was not reliance on importation of refined petroleum products, which has defied such solution, while building a domestic refining capacity to cater for the domestic market. And under foreign scene, the names of the three former African leaders feature prominently in what is generally believed to be the biggest financial data leak in history. They are Egypt's former president Hosni Mubarak, Libya's late leader Muammar Gaddafi, and one-time president of Sudan Ahmed Ali al-Mirghani. The data contains secret offshore companies linked to the families and associates of Mubarak, Gaddafi, Ali al-Mirghani, and Syria's President Bashar al-Assad. The huge leak of confidential documents known as the Panama Papers reveals how the rich and powerful use tax havens to hide their wealth. The scandal blew open when 11 million documents were leaked from one of the world's most secretive companies, Panamanian law firm Mossack Fonseca. They show how Mossack Fonseca has helped clients launder money, dodge sanctions, and evade tax. The company says it has operated beyond reproach for 40 years and has never been charged with criminal wrongdoing. Speaker of South African's Parliament, Baleke Mbete, has announced that it will debate a motion to impeach President Jacob Zuma on Tuesday. The debate on the motion has been scheduled for April 5th. The call for President Zuma impeachment debate came a day after anti-apartheid veteran Ahmed Kathrada joined opposition leaders in calling for Zuma's resignation. President Zuma has ignored orders from the public prosecutor to return some of the $60 million in state funds that he used to renovate his mansion situated at KwaZulu-Natal province. Gun battles rocked the capital of Congo Republic on Monday, shattering a relative claim that had followed President Denis Sassou-Nguesso's re-election in a disputed poll last month. Government spokesman Terry Moagala said former members of the Ninja Militia that fought Sassou-Nguesso in a 1997 civil war raided and set alight military, police and local government offices, but the attacks have been contained. Opposition leader Guy Brice-Parfait Kolisa came second in the March 20 election, and his father led the Ninjas during the Civil War. The group signed a peace accord with the government in 2003 after years of sporadic clashes, though rivalries persisted along regional and ethnic lines. Iranian Army official and Deputy Chief Liaison of the Army Ground Force, General Ali Araste, told Iran's Tasnim news agency that Iran's army deployed special forces from the 65th No-Hit Brigade on an advisory mission. Analysts believe the move, which is drawing the Iranian military presence every inch closer to Israel with an eye on the Jewish state. And for more stories, please log on to our website at www.africanfreepress.com. Like our Facebook page at African Free Press. Don't forget to join in our discussions at African Free Press Forum. Follow us on Twitter at African Free Press and subscribe to our YouTube channel at African Free Press. My name is Bridget Okudile.